As a budding graphologist, what should I do? This is the question from most of the graphologists. So let me tell you how you should approach a learning in graphology. First, you should always be learning from one single mentor in the beginning of your career. You don't go on YouTube. You don't read different books. You follow one mentor and one advice for longer time so that your basics becomes very, very strong. Let's assume you do this for 6 months or a year, then you can go and check other mentors, books, and videos as well. But before that, if you go and check plenty of videos, plenty of books, it will leave you confused. So this is the first advice. Follow a single mentor in the beginning of your career. The second advice is never fall in love with the graphology. Sounds weird, but it is the truth. If you want to be very, very successful as a graphologist, the knowledge only will not fetch you money or success or fame or popularity. Along with the knowledge, what you need is the knowledge of how to do marketing, how to do sales, how to promote yourself, how to use social media, how to run ads. So never ever just fall in love with graphology, but also pay attention to all the peripheral things which are required to build a career in graphology. The third advice, which I would like you all to follow, is only focus on important things in the handwriting. So whenever you are giving a graphotherapy to someone, or if you are applying graphotherapy to yourself, then make sure that you're only changing the important things of his personality, which will bring him success. I see plenty of graphologists suggesting to change G, J, Y, then A, B, C, up to Z, every single letter. Whatever you have achieved in your life is a product of your own personality. And these letters are there with your personality. So if you change everything, it means you will have to learn new ways of adjusting and adapting your mindset. Right? So this may or may not be beneficial for you right now. So make sure that whenever you are giving a graphotherapy to yourself or to the person, only few characters you need to change in your handwriting so that you get amazing results. So this is the third advice. Number four advice. When you are building your career in graphology, never be shy of sharing your knowledge with other graphologists and your students. The market is abundant. Market is full of knowledge and full of customers, full of students. So don't be shy on sharing the knowledge which you have. Don't be afraid that if you give this much, what will happen? From where the next knowledge come? Believe me, I have been in your state. I used to hide a lot of knowledge. I used to not share many things. And what happened? I was mediocre. I was not growing enough. The moment I started sharing more knowledge with the people, with the students, I started to grow like a giant. Today, we have crossed more than 5,000 students. And this all happened just because I started sharing more. So this is the advice for all of you who are trying to build a career in graphology.